Good evening time, everybody. Good evening time. 018 here, Donkey Stomper. Please take time to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel if you're not already. Please take time to join our YouTube channel. Appreciate the new members that joined. I said we had our first giveaway of the day. Hopefully there's more to come. We have got a junkyard 1x4 box. This box has been around, boys. I think everybody around here has owned it one time or another. And it's always had HG2079s in it. I'm not sure. I think it was originally built by 440 over. I think he passed away. Somebody said, I don't know. But anyway, it's always had a heavy power supply in it. The problem is this thing idles about 22 volts. When you key up, it holds about 18. It's had so many sets of pills in it. Oh, my Lord. Oh, Lordy mercy. What a mess. It was mean, though. So finally, one of my friends got it. Old Mud Flap down here, local. And he got a hold of it. And it was blowed up. And we put a used HG in it. And it run about a little while, and it blowed up. We put another used HG in it, and he run it off a regular power supply where I put these leads back here for a while. But the guy before him that had it, he brought it to me. And it was, it was junk, man. I put new transformers in it, rewound everything, put new relay in, new key circuit. I redid it all. The board looks like crap. But I had to put new pill strips in. Electrically, it's correct. So, it kept bothering Mud Flap blowing pills. So, here we are. So, what we did, and I think this might be an answer to everybody for a fix for all these Encore leaners. We've got Encore amplifiers still floating around everywhere, guys, and they're still floating at 20 volts and 17 and 18 and all that. I don't know if the C's would have held. The C's might have held, but I didn't want to try it. I'm tired of wasting this box. This might be a fix to get you by to fix these old Encore amps. That way we don't have to throw them away or rebuild them. There's X-Forces out there everywhere with floating power supplies. Fat Boys, Vipers, everything. So, what we did, so we're going to see how this works. I put the 28-volt transistors in it. Brand new set of 2510s. And I know it's rough looking. I didn't burn that board up like that. It was like that when I got it. But I did patch it up. And like I said, electrically, it's correct. It'll work. Pretty? No. It's ugly. But, anyway... It's got 24-volt fans in it now, iron core. And it's got 24-volt fans, 28-volt transistors. It's actually only holding 18 of the key, so it's going to lower the power a little bit, but that's okay. We just want it to work, man. And so this might be an answer for these guys running all these iron cores, these old iron cores. It's got Shibas in them, and they can't afford to do nothing. You might just put you some 28-volt transistors in there and do a little tuning, make sure input tune, output tune's low, and go with it. Alrighty, guys, let's see what to do. We'll start out straight through SWR like we always do. Hello, audio. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Hello, hello. 0. Here's my radio. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Hello, come in. Channel idle. So there's two sensors. And I'll show y'all something about meters. You think jumpers don't make a difference? Check this out. Alright, hold on. This is my first sensor. There's one right behind the radio. Hello, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. This is my second sensor behind the amp down there by the dummy load.
Hello, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2.
Like I said, everything you put in line, everything you do makes a difference. I noticed the other day my ohmage was about 40 on my jumper right there, so I probably need to change this jumper. I put some ends on it, I probably knocked it out of tune, but anyway, that's all right. I bet it's had 10 ends put on it where I've been, off and on boxes all the time. All right, guys, let's turn him on. Verb wide open.
We're decking 1 watt in, swinging 30s. Input tune, hello, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 0.
Here's our PEP on the LP.
Hello, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Hello, audio. Audio.
So what, 900 watts? 5 volt reverse.
Hello, 1, 2, 3, halfway back,
right on target.
2,500-watt PEP. We should have 1,000-watt sucking there, but don't. Be reading that top scale. Hello, 800 change. But that's fine. But like I said, the wattage ain't the deal, man. We want to save the box. Transistor staying good and cool. We want to save the box. We want to stay running, you know. That's what I'm saying. I've had people up in East Tennessee and stuff message me with their old X-Forces, iron core, and it's like, I just blowed a couple pills or got some resistors blow. And I got Toshibas in there. And they said, what are we going to do? I said, you're going to change all the transistors. Well, I think this could be the answer, guys. Put the 2510s in them iron core boxes and keep them working. Keep them alive. They'll lose some wattage, yeah, because they're not 28 volts. We're not putting up 18 volts queued up, but still, if it does lose wattage, it's better than throwing the amp away. At least it'll stay working. Hello, 1x4. 1x4. Hello, audio 1, 2, 3. Hello, audio. Let's say we're deck in. We're deck in. Hold on. 1.8 watts in right there. It says, hello, audio 1, 2, 3. So, not bad. I said no fan on it. Everything's staying cool. Input tune's good. Output reflex good. He'll have it in my box. He'll even sell my 800-watt bass box. Alrighty, guys, there it is. The junkyard box. Getting on down. Appreciate y'all watching. Like I said, please take time to like, subscribe to our YouTube channel if you're not already. Please take time to join our membership if you'd like to. We appreciate you. Appreciate the support. Appreciate everything from everybody. We know here at Donkey Stomper, we wouldn't be here. All right, guys, take care. Your friend 10, 018 Beavis. Donkey Stomper. Catch you later. Bye-bye.